Christoph Mug earlier this season. He won himself the rodeo in Bella Coolidge here 2 weeks ago on the bareback riding event, and now he's here to try to be the champion again today. He's got that horse, Jimmy Big Time. Jimmy Big Time hoping to take the cowboy Big Time to the pay window as Christoph Mug of Hazleton pulls his hat down, crosses across the top of the back of that horse, and now all he's got to do is put his hand into that suitcase shirt shaped rigging and hang on for an 8-second ride. And Christoph Mug, shoot number 5, is where the action is. He's on that big horse, the one that's Jimmy Big Time for the D&B Rodeo Company. Oh, in this section of the bareback riding, we'll go down to the side of it and the face. Christoph Mug on his horse and Jimmy Big Time taking a big time across the ring. And it's Cowboy Ride him, Christoph Mug. He got a successful ride, and give him a big round of applause to the Hazleton man. We're tabulating our scores from the Cowboy. You're going to see him back here in section number 2 this afternoon. We're riding another bareback horse to see if he's a champion. He is judged at 1-25 on his riding ability. A 1-25 with a bucking kick in action, that bucking horse, for a total possible 100 points. A 70-point ride, they tell me, a 7-0. Good enough for third spot so far in the bareback riding event. A 70-point ride for Christoph Mug. Quick mark, there's a quick release on the gaff deck, and the gaff is released into the arena. In the middle of that rope, the light shoestring, and the cowboy's a little bit too quick. The cowboy's horse rips that shoestring and breaks the barrier, and he'll get a 10-second penalty. Unfortunately, the cowboy sort of looped down on the ground and gets a no time. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, no time for Russell Glasper. Believe in this event. Draws his head, hooks head outside, throws a loop down, he's got a whole lot of gap. Not what he wanted, it makes it a little difficult when he's got the two hind feet caught. But Willie Twan's the type of man that can get the job done. Roping horse working well for the cowboy, brings up the hind feet, goes for the wrap, the hitch. He's all done. Looks like we're clean on the barrier as well for the cowboy. Now he must remain on up, and the calf must remain tied for a total of 6 seconds. That's what Gord Mahalo, our rodeo judge, gives the nod. We got a 15-8, they tell me, for Willie Twan. A 15-8 is the running time. Now we're down to Steve Lord, a young cowboy from out of the Quesnel country. He is one of the top contenders in this event. He was the 2014 finals champion of the tie-down open event. And earlier this season, he won the Barrier True Grit Indoor Rodeo and the Williams Lake Indoor as well as Clinton. He heads down, he's got a through a loop down and not off, and you see that cowboy come up with an empty rope. He takes it up in no time. Give him a great big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, no paycheck for the cowboy this afternoon in the tie-down open. Cowboy knocked his head to the outside. Steve Pothamon got himself a black calf. Crowd come alive, help him out. Help him throw a skew down the calf down the ground. And he's all done. Give him a big round of applause. Looks like we're clean on the barrier as well for the cowboy, for Steve Pothamon. Well, a running time of 8.9, and there's your new leader, ladies and gentlemen. Steve Pothamon with an 8-9 is the new leader. Big paint horse back in the barrier box. This horse works well for Jerry to make a great team as he heads across that rodeo arena. Pulls the loop down, he's got himself a longhorn gap. Now crowd help him out as he takes it up the hopping. 1, 2, 3, he's all done. Looks like a clean run on the barrier as well. The judge says it's a clean run. We tabulate our time for the cowboy. The gap must remain tied for a total of 6 seconds. An 8-9 currently in the lead by Steve Pothamon in this event. A 9-5, they tell me a 9-5 for our cowboy, good enough for third spot so far with a 9-5.
Nice, no, good tomorrow.
Roy Jerry gets himself set up in the barrier box, gives a nod, charges out. Big gun horse charges down, and Roy Jerry throws the loop down the ground. Give him a big round of applause, and that's unfortunately all that he takes home this afternoon is that applause, which is always greatly appreciated. Riley is now back in the barrier box. The rope is stretched across, and this cowboy's ready to rope one of these longhorn calves in the D&B rodeo. Throw the loop down. And ladies and gentlemen, hoop, help him out. Get the adrenaline going. Don't be afraid to hoot and holler. You paid money at the gate. We're not asking you to be quiet by any means. Have fun. Enjoy your afternoon. Looks like we're clean on the barrier as well, Mr. Isnardi. Calf just must be made tied for a total of 6 seconds for time to be called. gives the nod, and we have a running time of 10 and 9. A running time of 10 and 9. So unofficially, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Jepson Petroleum tie-down rope event goes to Steve Pazabon with an 8.9. Give our tie-down rope a hand, ladies and gentlemen. That completes the tie-down rope event for 2015 here at the 10th Annual Canoe Mountain Rodeo. Nods his head, says outside, Chris. Soft fugue, ride him, cowboy, ride, cowboy. He's got a whole lot of bucking horse under him. Give him a hand and judge him how the stopwatch that we go by. It's their decision this afternoon what he's going to give. They give him a thumbs up. He made it for the 8-second ride, ladies and gentlemen. Give him a big round of applause for that cowboy. Wait for the judge to decision and what kind of a score we give to the cowboy for Christoph Mew before we go down to the line of the end of things for the steer wrestling. A 71-point ride, ladies and gentlemen, a 71, and there's the new leader in the saddle bronc riding event, a 71 for Christoph. Nope, that's not right. I'm sorry. Oh, a 58. Sorry about that, Christoph. A 58, my misunderstanding. A 58-point ride puts him in first spot in the saddle bronc riding. Drop that little arena, reach it down. Oh, down to the ground. A hard way to make a living for the young man. Give him a big round of applause. His dad, a long-time contender in the steer wrestling event, helping the young fellow to the ground. On the ground, it looks like he might have got a little bit of the wind knocked out of the young man. Give him a big round of applause and a no-time, unfortunately, for Blaine Manuel in a no-time. You know, you got to be quick on the takeoff. You've got to have your horse focused on that longhorn steer. And most of all, you got to make sure that everybody and everything is in sync. I mean, steer focused on the bar in the arena. Horse focused on the steer, cowboy in charge of it all. And all the heads went outside, charged it down across that arena after a hard running steer. The steer turns off on him, makes it a little difficult for the cowboy to get a good shot at it. Waves him off and takes him no time. Give him a big round of applause and a no time for Colton Mania. Form keeps that steer straight and true, running down the rodeo arena. Following the steer wrestling event, we go down the breakaway ropes, so breakaway ropers get ready. Riding in there to reach it down. Crowd, help him along! He's going to need all the strength he can get to throw that steer to the ground. Riding in there, wrestling cowboy. Hang on to him, young man. Crowd screaming, holler, getting the grip of that. Riding in there, come on, cowboy, you can do it. Put some muscle into a young man. Put a whole lot of muscle into it. Cheer him on, young man. He's got a lot of steam with the horn. And there she goes. Give a big round of applause. We tell me there's time for the cowboy. But a 28 and 9, they say. A 28 and 9. A 28 and 9, and good enough for second spot with a 28 and 9. Ronnie is dirty. Give him a big round of applause. Takes home second spot. That's the second man to make a qualified run in the steer wrestling this afternoon. Come on back to the announcer booth, please. Here's Billboy. William Blake Cowboy throws a loop down. Another little bit of fishing. Unfortunately, takes a no time. Give her a big round of applause and a no time for Cowboy. And gives a nod, the steer's released, he throws the loop down, and unfortunately takes a no time. Not often you see that cowgirl end up with an empty rope and a no time for Allison Everett. Barry Roper stretch the cross on our next roper, Richard Glassford on the Quinnell, getting himself set up and ready to go here this afternoon. Off the head to the outside, Richard charges down, throws a long loop, whoa, up the top of the head of that steer, it takes a no time and a no time for Richard Glasper. The old Katie Billy Boy, William Blake Cowgirl, got herself back to the barrier box, and he's set up and ready to go, he'll his out. He gives a nod, charges down to that rodeo arena, and she's got herself a catch, breaks away, and that's how it's done. That's the first clean run. Hit day number two of rodeo action. Well, the running time of 3.6, the running time of a 3-6. Kristen Lohe has got herself back in that barrier box. Arthur Henson outside, charged it down hard and fast. Throw the loop, and she got one, breaks it away. Give her a big round of applause for Kirsten Lohead of Hefty Creek. For the running time of a 5.4, the running time of a 5-4. Arthur Henson, let me have one of the hard to catch black steers. Charged it down, and she got herself a steer. Breaks away, and that's how she done. 19-1 for the cowgirl, Terry Perry. The running time of 5-6. A 5-6, the running time for Tara Perry, a 5-6. This is young Taylor Cherry, modern Quinnell, BC. Following this young lady will go with Kayla Jasper, will be the one on deck. Once again, this is Taylor Cherry, a young lady from modern Quinnell, BC. Got herself back to the very box. Rather Henson outside, charge it down. This young lady down to the ground, it takes no time. Fortunately, no time for Taylor Cherry, and no time. Barrier rope stretched across. Rather Henson outside, charge it down, throws it in the dirt, picks it up, and no time. Give her a big round of applause, and no time. Going to officially lay the dead on the winner of the breakaway rope in a bit. Goes to Charlie Soffa from yesterday afternoon with a 2.6. This cowboy knows he's got a lot of horse on him here this afternoon. Settling down on the back of his horse, simply known as Tricked Out from D&D Rodeo Company. Nods the headset outside and ride him, cowboy, ride him! Ride Christoph Hughes, that horse going every which direction that cowboy's riding. Give him a big round of applause. Christoph Hughes, the Hamilton man, picked it out, took it a little easier on him today than it did on Cash Turner yesterday. Now they're tapping in our time score for the Cowboy. The judge is judging 1-25 and his riding ability. Heads up behind you there, Christoph. A 1-25 on the riding ability of the Cowboy, 1-25 on the bucking action of that horse. 79 by Cash Turner, currently in the lead. A 69 point ride, ladies and gentlemen, a 69. And that completes the bareback riding event for 2015. And the winner of that event, Cash Turner, the young man for Pritchard, with a 79 point ride yesterday afternoon. He is the winner in the bareback riding. And once again, I'd like to thank the lovely ladies for bringing up the cake, the ice cream, and the berries. They are in that independent little concession booth behind the grandstand, so be sure to visit them this afternoon. And Steve Holman on Mercury Rising. Ride, Mr. Holman, ride! Whoa! Give him a big round of applause. And that man, ladies and gentlemen, like I said earlier, had himself a bit of a wreck yesterday. Got lawn darted into the ground. And there for a little while, he had hardly any feeling in the upper body, but this man is one of the toughest cowboys you'll ever see on the back of a saddle bronc horse. And unfortunately, no score for the Cowboy. Then Christoph Hughes is the last and final saddle bronc rider of the entire rodeo. He's currently winning this event with a 58-point ride. He nods his head and says, let me have him on Kiss This. Get ready, Cowboy. You got a whole lot of horse to ride. And that's the hardest part on any cowboy's nerves when you open the chute gate and your horse refuses to come out. Kind of psychs the cowboy up. Kind of gets the nerves and the ball. He is the next cowboy to go. Christoph Hughes gonna Kiss This. Nods his head to the outside and Kiss This is not wanting to cooperate at all with our cowboy. Getting them all psyched out down there. Neil Antoine, our pickup man down there helping out, getting some early advice earlier from some of our cowboys on how to do the job. He's one of the top cowhands you'll see in any rodeo arena. Knows what it takes to get a horse to buck over an 8-second ride.
And over me, he gets drinking. You were drinking. All he's playing there.
Kiss This is the name of the horse. Christoph Muge, a young man from Hazleton. He's already rode 3 bucking horses. He's already made 3 successful rides this afternoon. Bob is headed outside. Christoph Muge has got a bucking horse and riding cowboy riding. Hang on the road, living on the ground. Give him a big round of applause for the cowboy. That is 4 horses that cowboy got on today and rode 75% of those horses for an 8-second ride. But ladies and gentlemen, he's still the champion. He's the cowboy that won a saddle bronc riding event. She was second place earlier this season at the Clinton Mayball Rodeo. Gracie Antoine charges down, throws a loop down the ground. Unfortunately, will take home in no time. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and no time for the young cowgirl here this afternoon. And now we're down to Brock Everett, the next young cowboy to go. In the junior breakaway roping event, this young cowboy also comes from a rodeo family. Jerry Rope getting stretched across, and Brock Everett trying to look at a 3.4, at least what he needs to be a champion in this event. Long the hits it outside, charges down. Brock Everett rolls a loop down on the ground and takes himself a no time. Give him a big round of applause and a no time for Brock Everett of 150 Mile House. And now we get on to Hardy Antoine. She was the 2014 season leader last year. There you go, stretched across, and the young cowgirl is focused on that steer to come charging to that rodeo arena at breakneck speed. Harley Antoine, Mother Henson, let me have at it. Rolls a loop down, and down on the ground, and no time. No time for Harley Antoine. 3-5 is the current winner in this event so far. Mary Rope stretched across, this young cowgirl getting herself set up and hoping to be a champion, which she's got in her mind. She needs at least a 3-4 in order to be the champ. Taylor Cherry throws one down into the ground and hits a no time. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big round of applause. No qualified runs this afternoon. And as it stands, Brianna Billy, the winner of the junior breakaway roping, with a running time of a 3.5. Once again, young Wayne Manor will be the cowboy to go with this event. So far this afternoon, we have 9 youngsters to get on junior steers. The Boulder can crown a champion. A 76-point ride by Cole Wallace from yesterday afternoon, currently leading this event. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Not often you see that young man thrown down to the ground. Neil, just kind of hold that down there, please, Neil. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That young cowboy can hear you loud, and he can hear you clear. For the young man, Blaine Manuel. He said, let me have a steer. Give him a big round of applause, and another young man thrown down to the ground. And a nose goal this afternoon for Braden Robbins. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. She can hear you loud and clear. And another young cowgirl down on the ground and an old score. Hey. and gentlemen, another cowboy thrown to the ground. So far, these cows from D&B Rodeo are throwing the youngster to the ground. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. That's all he's going to take home is your applause. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen. No disgrace to get bucked off of this caliber of cow here this weekend. Our next young cowboy to go, I do believe, will be Tyler Lang. Will be a nice cowboy to go. A big round of applause for Tyler Lang. Go for the judges' stopwatch, and Gord Mahalo's looking at his. Big round of applause. That kid had one heck of a ride. He was up and over and around on both sides of a big red cow. And the nose scored on off. And you see that young man throwing down to the ground. Now they're getting ready for Kevin Wallace, the last and final junior steer rider in 2015 before we can crown a champion. Kevin Wallace, a young man from Valemount, British Columbia. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you've got a whole lot of rodeo action yet this afternoon. You got bull riding, barrel racing, team roping. We've got it all this afternoon. This is Kevin Wallace. He's the last and final junior steer rider of your rodeo. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for the young cowboy, Kevin Wallace, and a no score this afternoon. Saddles on, everybody's got back saddles in place. No farmer's horse doesn't want to totally cooperate. He doesn't like the rain out there at all. This could get wild, it could run western. Bob Griffin, you need to get yourself a racetrack and make it a whole lot more interesting on the back road race. Looks like the little Gene Scotland has already got the back saddle on. The panniers are going on. No farmer's putting one pannier on. And it's a close race, ladies and gentlemen. But by the looks of things, it looks like Gene Scotland may be the first one to get the back saddle on that horse that's done up. Going to be a tight race again this afternoon. Yesterday was a close race, and today looks like it could even be a close race as well. So pick your teams and don't be afraid to hoot and holler. They're all locals. You got your supporters back there, Steve Stewart Eyes, Isla Lorne, Katie Woodland on team number one. That's Team Scotland on the far side. The Snow Farmers team, Philip and Tony Parisi and Jory Pankinen. Getting themselves set up in this race. Team Scotland is mounted up. They're way out ahead. They're determined to win the race this afternoon. The all reigning champions from yesterday afternoon. George, you went on the stopwatch? You got the stopwatch. It'll be a while with the stopwatch by the looks of it. But it's okay, you know, Tony at his age, you gotta take it easy on these guys when they get to a certain age. Looks like the folks from Steam Scotland's gonna give them a fair head start. Dave Gutman darted down on the barrel. You gotta go all the way around that barrel, young lady. Jory Packing him loaded up. Go around it, young lady. Just don't get hit running to each other, guys. Don't hit each other. Hold on, whoa! Jory Packing him, you gotta have your horse and go, young man. Come on back, Jory. That is your horse there. Grab the rope. That's it, grab the rope. They'll take it around the barrels. This is the jury. Towards the announcer booth. There we go. And the race is on for Jury against the stopwatch. Bring it on, Jury. The dust is a flying. The hooves are going down around. He makes a left-hand turn around. He did make the left turn around the barrel. Give him a big round of applause. Hang on, Jury. Head on home. That horse would like to do a little bit of a crow hop and buck as we tabulate our time. And that, ladies and gentlemen, completes the pack horse race for day number two. We tabulate our time. And Tony, did you find your horse? You found it. The race was today. We just went to them and tabulated our times. George, do you have our times for us?
3:31:37 for Tony.
3:31:37?
Yep.
3:31:37 for Tony. And for the winning team, did anybody get the time on that one?
2:39.
A 2:39.
Yep.
And according to us, they are the winners. Tony, I hate to tell you this, but you lost the buckle, buddy. The ladies showed you exactly how it's done. Give them a big round of applause. Team Scotland, the champions overall with the fastest time for the 2 days overall. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Shailene Tucker, the little lady from out of William Blake with a running time of 15.695, 15.695. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Deanna Lloyd with a running time of 15.190. And then Jody Gilson. Give her a big round of applause. She takes it on home. Old Pete working well for the cowgirl with a running time of 15.230 is the running time. Give her a big round of applause for Jessica on the camera for the running time of 15.406 to 15.406. It's Michaela Turner on the banner. Michaela out and around number one, the big black horse working well for her, going around the number two barrel. Give her a big round of applause, Michaela Turner, banner hoop cowgirl, for a running time of 15.923, 15.923, the running time.
Yes. No.
Horse digging in and working well for her. She heads home, Cassidy Stanky, with a running time of 15.463. A 15.463 running time. Melanie Brown, your hometown sensation, coming into barrel number one. They're around two. The young lady's got a good run happening so far. The black horse working well for this young cowgirl. And around two, give her a big three, give her a big round of applause. Melanie Brown with a running time of 16, 1-1-8 to 16. 1-1-8, Mariah Mamrie, followed by Kyle Ball, on deck. Judith Colport of Valemount will be in the hole. This is Mariah Mamrie. Mariah Mamrie, another round, number three, give her a big round of applause for the cowgirl out of Canoe with a running time of 16-2-8-0. 16-2-8-0 is the running time. Kind of charging hard and fast, looking for the number three barrel. And around number three, give her a big round of applause for Tyler Moss on the Vanderhoof with a running time of 16.398 is the running time. Somebody out there know Julie. She's your hometown cowgirl. She'll be followed by Danielle Rotter on deck, and Tara Lawrence will be in the hole. Give her a hand, she's bringing it on home for Julie Colport, right here from Valemount. And the running time this afternoon is 25-217. 25-217 is the running time. Our next cowgirl will be Daniela Runner, right here from Valemount. How many out there know Daniela? Another hometown cowgirl right here, followed by Tara Lawrence on deck, and Hannah Turner will be in the hole. Daniela Rotter out of Valemount, down to the number three barrel. Give her a big round of applause for Daniela as she heads home here this afternoon with a running time of 20.633 to 20.633. Tara Lawrence, Walla Walla, Washington, Calgary. The goal will be down to the Jim Wolf Memorial Fund Junior Barrel Racing. Tara Lawrence out of round number two, down to the far end for number three, the third and final barrel. Give her a big round of applause. She heads it on home here this afternoon for Tara Lawrence with a running time of 14.889 and 14.889. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes the ladies' barrel racing event. As we rank our barrels, come back into the General Memorial Fund Barrel Racing. According to my tabulation, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the ladies' barrel racing event goes to Fallon Fosbury out of Merritt, BC, with a running time of 14.206. Even more, ladies and gentlemen, process size 14.856 in first spot. Brianna Billy with a 15.010 second. Sophia Smith, 15.262 is in third spot. Rounding up the roster in fourth, Katie Hollow with a 15.538. This young lady right here, Hannah Turner, with a running time of 15.579 plus 5 is a total running time of 20.579. 20.579. Now she's here to show her stuff in the barrel races. Give her a hand, she heads it home for Harley Antoine with a running time of 15.684 plus 5 is a total running time of 20.684. And you're running your hometown cowgirl, so don't be afraid to hoot and holler, cheer her on. It'll be Hannah Vanderwolf will be the next one to go. Emma Langevin on deck, and Carson Trotter will be in the hole. This is Hannah Vanderwolf, the hometown cowgirl.
Help me.
Give her a big round of applause for your hometown cowgirl, Hannah Vanderwilt. Excuse me, no time for the cowgirl. Go off that start line and hopefully no time. The next cowgirl to go from out of Glendale will be Emma Landerman. The next cowgirl to go, Emma Landerman. Out of Glendale is our next cowgirl. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. She takes it on home for Emma Landerman. For a running time of 15.809. 15.809. Alyssa Byford will be in the hole. And to get into Colton's water, the hometown cowgirl. Give her a hand for your hometown cowgirl, Constance Rodeo. Well, the running time of 22.905, 22.905. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we go down to the next competitor. That'll be Jessica McDonald, the young lady from out of 150 Mile House. You saw her earlier in action in the Super Fury Rally. Now her turn to shine in the barrel racing. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. She's heading on home for Jessica McDonald. The running time of 15.416. 15.416 is the running time. How many out there know Alyssa Byford? Don't be afraid to hoot and holler when she comes home from that third barrel. That'll help her go a little bit faster. She's her hometown young lady. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for Alyssa Byford. That was right here from Valemount. Well, the very running time of 19.559 and 19.559. All right, young lady, go right here from Valemount as well. We go with Ellie Rose Dewey. How many know Ellie Rose Dewey? She'll be your next cowgirl right here, hometown young lady. Followed by Gracie Antoine on deck. Alexis Beck Glassford will be in the hole. Big round of applause. She had it on home here this afternoon for the young lady. And of course, she had no time, a broken pattern, and no time for Ellie Rose Dewey, and no time. Our next young cowgirl will go be Gracie Antoine out of Cass Street. The next one to go. She had herself a third place finish earlier in the season over at Carolinas. And now she's back here to be a champion this weekend. Once again, this is Gracie Antoine. Give her a big round of applause for the young lady, Gracie Antoine, with a running time of 16.528. 16.528, the running time for Gracie. Once again, this is young Alexis Glassford out of Quail. Trying to beat the running time by Tasha Sykes of 14.856. I think the time to beat so far. He's the junior barrel racer. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Alexis Glassford on the running time of 16.076 and 16.076. with a Taylor Jerry out of Canoe. Taylor out of round two, got a good run happening so far for the Cowgirl. And around three, give her a big round of applause. She heads it on home. A little bit of tough luck for our Cowgirl with a running time. 20.122 plus 5 is a total running time of 25.122 to 25.122. Ladies and gentlemen, unofficially, the winner of the Lady of the Junior Barrel Racing goes to Caution Sight with a running time of 14.856. Now we're down to our TV barrel racing event this afternoon. The other club out of Armstrong is at the whole TV barrel racing event. And the Cowgirl we go is Carrie Atkins out of Fort St. John. Around barrel number one, looking across for barrel number two. Give a big round of applause for Carrie Atkins this afternoon with a running time of 15.175 plus 5 to their 20.175 or 20.175. We go over our next Cowgirl on the rope. Brooklyn's laughing out of the rail. What about Rose Stevens on there? Brooklyn out of the round once. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, for young Brooklyn. Laughter this afternoon with a running time of 19.242 and 19.243. Logan Stevens heading down the far end for barrel number three, the third and final barrel. Give him a big round of applause. Nice clean run, young cowboy. For the running time, the 17.383. 17.383. Tony Brown will be in the hole. And Donna Reed is at 23.476 by Katie Shirk, currently in the lead of this event. It's Kara Perry. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for young Kara Perry. A running time of 22.530, and that is the new leader in place. The next one, though. Give her a big round of applause for Tara Stilly Boy, the Wiggles Lake Cowgirl. For the running time of 21.860 plus 5. It is for the running time of 26.860. She'll be followed by Danielle Rodder. Our next Gilly Billy Boy will be in the hole. Give her a big round of applause, Melanie Brown, your hometown cowgirl. For the running time of 23.247 plus 5. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, your hometown cowgirl, Danielle and Robert. Gilly Billy Boy charging in hard and fast. She is the last and final of the ladies' pole bender. The Gord go down to the junior pole bender. Give her a big round of applause, Kaylee Billy Boy with a running time of 23.196 at 23.196. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we go down to the junior pole bending event. The next cowgirl to go will be Hannah Vanderwalk out of Valemount, your hometown cowgirl, followed by Alyssa Clyford on deck. Box of Trotter will be in the hole. Hannah Vander Wolf right here from Valemount. Trying to be the running time on a 23.907, but she has still currently the lead. Katie Holland in second with a 24.384. Rihanna Dilley sitting in third spot with a 26.787. And then Sydney Shook rounding up the top four with a 29.018. This young color road is Hannah Vander Wolf. Give her a hand, Bill Mouchy, one of your old cowgirls, Hannah Vanderwilt. On the running time of 30.574. A hometown young lady as well. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, your hometown cowgirl, Alyssa Byford, out of Valemount with a running time of a 34.133, a 34.133. Another hometown cowgirl will be the next one to go. Taylor Cherry on deck. Ellie Rose Fueling will be in the hole for the last and final junior pole vendor here this afternoon. There's Process Broder right here from Valemount. Give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen, she heads it on home for Constance Rodder. The running time of 32.164, 32.164 is the running time. We now go down to Taylor Cherry, it'll be the next cowgirl to go from out of Cornell. Taylor Cherry, Cornell cowgirl. Jerry's got a good clean run happening so far for the young lady from out of Cornell. And give her a big round of applause, a nice clean run for the young lady with a running time of a 21.755. And that is the new leader with a 21.755. Our next cowgirl to go will be Ellie Rose Fueling. Will be the last and final junior four then before we get out in the field. It is Ellie Rose Fueling, the hometown cowgirl. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Ellie Rose Fueling. And unfortunately, no time for the young lady and no time for the young Lowell Steele, the next cowboy. Lowell Steele started in a super time pattern, doing a great job for this young man. This young cowboy knows how to run a set of poles. A nice clean run, getting a big round of applause for young Lowell Stevens. This afternoon with a running time of 26.786. Give her a big round of applause for the Fort St. John cowgirl, Callie Atkins, for the running time of 23.143, a 23.143 for the cowgirl. do believe, according to my tabulations, Allie Atkins, you are the champion of the Peavey Pole Bend Man event, according to my tabulations. Not always correctly, but according to my tabulations. A 6-4 by Levi Hughes and Tim Pelham currently in the lead of this event. Aaron Palmer's got that big bay horse back in the barrier box, rope is stretched across. Aaron Dobbs heads and let me try out one of his longhorn steers as he races across the arena. Roll the loop down, but comes up empty and they take a no time. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and a no time for Aaron Palmer and Shane Lohe. Now the Dobbs heads and outside, charges down across that rodeo arena. Roll the loop down, ends up with an empty rope. And that'll be a no time, unfortunately, for the team. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, and a no time for Allison Everett and Willie Twan, a no time. All the hands are outside. Richard Glasper, Sergeant Harlan, pass across the rodeo arena, goes for the horn shed. Dally that makes a turn. Steve Lloyd going for a set of heels. And that's how it's done. Looks like we're clean on the barrier as well, guys. A nice clean run. As we tabulate our time for our team here this afternoon. Well, the running time of 9-2. Good enough, I do believe, for four spots so far with a 9-2. Russell Glasper's got his horse back in the barrier box. Rope stretch across. On the hand, they charge down across that rodeo arena. Russell makes it down here around the saddle horn. Steve goes for a set of heels. That's how she's done. Clean all the way across the board. That's exactly the score for the team. A 7-5. Good enough for third spot so far. A 7-5. Allison draws her head, charges down across that rodeo arena, makes a long loop. Get the horn cat down and makes a turn. Trish going in for a set of heels. That's how she's done, but a plus five for one hind foot, unfortunately, and 5 seconds added on to their time. A 9-4 plus five is a 14-4, the total running time, a 14-4. Russell Glasper got a drop back to the very one, takes a nod, charges it down across that arena, rolls it off the top of the steer's head, they take a no time, and a no time for Russell and Richard Glasper, and a no time. All his head upstairs outside, Neil charges it down, goes to the horn check. Down it to make the turn, Shane over a set of heels. That's how she's done with 5 seconds added on to the time. Rolling one high, but it'll be definitely our time this afternoon. A 7-9 plus 5 with a 12-9. The total running time. So unofficially the winner of the team roping event goes to Levi Hughes and Tim Pelham with a running time of 6-4. Ladies and gentlemen, give all of our team ropers a hand as that completes the team roping for 2015. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we focus your eyes and your attention on the bucking chute. How many out there are ready for some bull riding? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was wild and western yesterday afternoon. We had 9 bull riders and only one cowboy rode for an 8-second ride. And it's gonna get wild, it's gonna get western, and it's gonna be trying to figure out a champion this afternoon. Only one qualified ride, and that was Jackson Scott. A young 18-year-old cowboy from out of Kamloops currently in the lead with a 72-point ride. Shoot number 4 is where the action's at. He's on the red, white-faced bull known as Headhunter. A hard-to-ride bull, but a bull that can take a cowboy to the pay window. The judges tabulated score. The gentleman 1-25 in his riding ability, a 1-25 in the bucking action of bull, for a total possible 100 points. Chris Lang, run back and forth and get our score for us, Cowboys. Now this guy can ride bulls. He's got himself that bull known as Too Cool Gear. This is the third time I've seen this man ride this bull. He scored an 85-point ride 2 weeks ago in Delacula. This bull is hard to ride. Successful ride out of four attempts in the last 2 weeks. And that kid has been doing good. The two cool chairs been good to that young man. Matt O'Flynn, be proud. Cowboy, be proud. A 78-point ride, and he's your new leader, ladies and gentlemen, with a 78-point ride. That is Matt O'Flynn with a 78-point ride. Please back away from the bulls, ladies and gentlemen. Back away from the fences. These bulls are not fussy what they hit. They have 2,000 pounds of power, but when you get that four of them a minute, you get about 4,000 pounds of G-force. And today, Sunday bull riders are riding good this afternoon. And another qualified bull ride here at the Valemount Canoe Mountain Rodeo. Point ride, ladies and gentlemen, a 75. Good enough for third spot so far, good enough for second spot with a 75. Matt O'Flynn currently in the lead with a 78. Once again, young Ryan St. Pierre. A 74-point ride for Jory Pinkerton. Good enough for third spot so far for Jory Pinkerton. And a 74-point ride. Our next cowboy to go will be Reed Fuller out of William Lake on a bull they call Dr. Hook. Williams Lake will be the next cowboy to go down and shoot number five. Give him a hand and down on the ground and a no score for the young cowboy. McCall, a young man from Outer Clinton, B.C. Came up for the ranks of rodeo from riding junior steers to now riding bulls. Good. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes the bull riding for 2015, and that completes our rodeo, the 10th annual rodeo here at the Valemount Rodeo Grounds, the Canoe Mountain Rodeo. We thank each and every one of you for coming out here. It's been a great pleasure with you fine folks, and hope to see you all back here again next year for an even bigger and better rodeo performance.